My name is Alexey Abramovsky. I'm the team leader of TIGA for architecture team. And I'm going to make a short presentation regarding this project. First, I'm going to describe what it was made for. And then I will try to describe the basic features we have added during the last year. Generally, TIGA Architecture is a tool for architectural design planning. It's a vertical application based on TIGA Core, but unlike Core libraries, where you have an access to basic primitives like lines, text, circles, and so on, TIGA for Architecture uses additional set of high-level primitives, which are designed for basically manipulating drawings which represent buildings and architectural plane. So those primitives are walls, doors, windows, stairs, and so on. For example, as an example of this point, you can see that the part of the previous building, and if you split it into separate objects, it will not split into low-level lines or something like that, but into high-level walls, stairs, and so on. Architectural objects are quite complex, but this is the explanation is beyond the topic of this presentation. Let's say that they have certain behavior, depends on, for example, beauty direction, customer settings, styles, and so on. For example, stairs to the right have this shape and this drawing, but you can customize it in any way possible, and it will still be a stair, and will interact with other architectural objects accordingly. Current project status. Architecture is a mature project which is now in maintenance state, and we have full support of architectural objects of all formats, from the oldest one to the newest 2018 format. We are able to read and write architectural objects correctly. We are able to render all architectural objects in two and three dimensional view. And we have API which allows to create and modify architectural objects for the use of third-party applications. So during last year we were working on Facet Modeler as the first point. Facet Modeler is an algorithm inside TIGA Architecture which allows to manipulate three-dimensional objects, actually faceted solids. And now, as you can see, there are a lot of improvements, and the current facet modeler is able to correctly manipulate with big complex sets of architectural primitives. For example, if you want to cut some building, which is a common case for TIGA for Architecture, it works correctly, and it allows to build construction documentation. Next, we're working on stairs. This is just an example of what stairs can look like in architecture. Both stairs are the same object with a different style. And you can see that if you rotate the stair into top view, it will draw itself differently. It's the same object on the drawing, but in top view, they are drawn not like a 3D primitive, but as a three-dimensional shape. So you can get plan view of your building automatically just by turning the view. And what we have done custom stairs. The style of the stair is an algorithm which creates the whole stair in the same way, but the final polishing now, you can convert the stair created into a custom stair and edit any thread and write there separately, for example, change the shape of the first and the last thread as the customer wants. Next, we will concentrate on section algorithm, which is a very important part of architecture. The core point of architectural drawing is a three-dimensional model, which is drawn by architectural primitive by an architectural designer. And then usually people want to create a set of two-dimensional drawings with certain style. For example, to represent a facade of a building, plan of a flat or of some house, or vertical section of the same house. And now it can be done automatically. I will demonstrate it a little bit later in live demonstration. But generally, those objects above are two-dimensional set of lines which are created automatically by an algorithm. So you can create any facade, a horizontal section or plan view from a 3D object, three-dimensional model. And it saves a lot of manual work for architectural designers. Now I'm going to demonstrate this algorithm for you with the current architecture. For example, we take this model which was on this presentation slide. This is the model of the building, and for example, the designer wants to create a facade of the building. And he just needs to select the point of view and direction of view, and then place the facade will be generated automatically. As you probably know, the final construction documentation usually consists of those two-dimensional drawings, and architecture can automate and simplify this process. Then, for example, I want to generate the horizontal section of the first floor, and this actually clip volume represents the section line here, the line in which the model will be cut. And again, I am going to generate the cut, and as you can see, you can automatically create construction documentation from a general 3D model. On the same model, you can make a horizontal section of the second floor, for example. You just need to place another key volume and select place on drawing, and as you can see, this is already the section, horizontal section of the second floor. The point is that if you, for example, want to change something in the model, for example, let's try and delete some walls in the model, some walls and windows, and then you can just refresh all sections in the drawing, and now as you probably noticed, that left wall has disappeared. The point is that this helps to keep all construction documentation up to date. You have to have only the central 3D model, and from it you can build automatically all construction documentation of specific style. You can assign some hatch, line types, and different styles which are needed for a country. And then, if something changed in the 3D model, we can regenerate the whole construction documentation and it will be up to date. If it were a building of 100 floors, for example, it would be too complex to redraw each floor and don't forget anything. And this feature helps the designers in their work. So, now, this is actually the final step of presentation. Questions and comments?
Is it possible to define custom architectural elements?
Yes.
Including their appearance on the on those architectural drawings.
Yes, you can architectural objects are just custom AutoCAD objects. So you can create your own custom objects, and you have to keep in mind the rules in which those objects interact on with each other. And if you keep them, if you implement those rules, it will be just like a short.
Okay, there are no more questions.